My name's Sarah Bayliss, and I'm a painting conservator. After I studied chemistry at university, I had not really heard about conservation until my friend who studied art history mentioned it to me. And it took me a little while to actually find out what it entailed, what it was all about. But when I did look into it, I was very excited. Conservation is about caring for artworks and also making sure that they look the best that they can and that they are stable for people to look at in the future. I think what I really love about conservation is how many different disciplines kind of converge within it. So I studied chemistry and I'm really interested in materials paintings are made out of and how they change over time. Then there's also the kind of historical aspect. As soon as you do start thinking about paintings as being objects and having like a physical presence, there's so much that opens up in terms of what has happened to them in the last however many hundred years they have existed, what might happen to them in the future, if they've changed in any way, like did it always look like that, or has, you know, the pigment degraded, has it been in a flood, has it been torn from a palace and shipped halfway across Europe. We look at what paintings are made out of and how those materials change, their chemistry. We look at what materials artists were using at that time, what's typical for that period. Maybe how an artist is doing something unique or different, or why somebody has chosen a specific material to make their painting out of. Does it have a particular importance or symbolism? Did the materials they used, was that their choice or was that just what was available? Were they trying to make a point with their use of that material? In painting conservation, you know, you do have to consider the artist's intent.
It's not doing anywhere now. It's the initial purpose.
It's great working at the museum. We have a team working here. We've currently got 3 painting conservators.
Hello, my name's Kitty, and I'm Senior Paintings Conservator here at Amgueddfa Cymru. When I was 17, my art teacher brought in a video of the conservation of The Last Supper by Leonardo da Vinci. I'd never seen anything like it before. This whole team of people were deciding how this wonderful, well-known artwork was going to be represented for years to come. It was a completely new thing to me. It seemed to involve a lot of teamwork, a lot of problem solving. There was science, there was art history. I was completely hooked. I was lucky enough to get a fully funded internship at the Tate Galleries in London. That just gave me an absolutely amazing insight into the world of working in a museum. And I knew right then that that's what I wanted to do with my career. Working in a museum is so different to working freelance. You have a whole collection to take care of. You get to monitor them through their whole life. It's just such a wonderful privilege to be able to interact with these objects so intimately. The role of conservation here at Amgueddfa Cymru is to take care of the collection and to try and present it in the way that's most accurate with the artist's original vision. That might include if a painting has become very yellow because the varnish has sort of degraded over time, we might decide in conversation with the art curators to remove that yellowed varnish and give it a nice new synthetic clear varnish so that the painting looks much more the way it would have when it was first painted. If we have a beautiful, fresh, modern and contemporary painting, we really want to prevent anything happening to that work, so we might do all kinds of hidden preventive measures such as putting little support boards in the back of the canvas and things just to prevent any accident happening in the future whilst the work is being moved or transported. We take care of the paintings and we make them accessible to the public because at the end of the day this is the public's collection.
For modern and contemporary art, it is really important and a great opportunity to be able to talk to artists about, you know, what kind of materials they used for their artwork, how they want it to be displayed sometimes, maybe what their intentions were, how they feel about conservation methods and what they would be comfortable with us doing. I think a lot of people maybe don't think that modern or contemporary paintings need conserving, but a lot of the times they might be made from unconventional materials which have their own problems and may need intervention sooner rather than later.
My particular field of interest in conservation is the conservation of modern and contemporary works. They are quite different to the way that you would treat a historic painting. The main thing you're kind of battling with a historic painting is probably its history. Normally they were made with a really solid technique. Artists for many, many centuries just tried to perfect the technique of putting that paint on that canvas in the most stable way possible. Historic paintings, you're normally trying to work out what has happened to that work to bring it in the state that it is currently in. But with modern paintings, you come into a sort of a world where artists are quite rightly using anything they want. There's a lot of focus on the concept of the painting, and that could be why they've used certain materials. And kind of all these different things mean that modern paintings tend to be a little bit more vulnerable to the environment and to life. And there's some really odd things can happen to modern paints. Over time, they might not dry quite as well as historic paints would have. So you might find really interesting phenomena like paintings starting to reliquify after about 10 or 20 years, and the paint will start to ooze out from the inside. If we know that a painting is going out on loan and it's going to be subjected to perhaps some fluctuations in temperature or humidity during its journey, we can do something called a microclimate. And a microclimate is where you make a little envelope essentially with the painting and the glazing using aluminium foil and aluminium tape. And this creates a lovely little envelope with kind of a buffered and known humidity inside of it. And we then place that envelope inside of the frame. And that just gives the whole thing a nice buffered environment during transport. Paintings come into the collection in a number of different ways. Sometimes they're a gift from a donor, or sometimes our art curatorial team will identify very specific areas of the collection that they would like to fill. We're the very first stop when the painting actually comes into the building, and it's at that point that we begin to look at this object and we'll do a really thorough documentation of the object.
Usually the first thing that we do when we get a painting is we need to assess it. We need to assess its condition. We need to find out or infer what materials it's made out of, because that will have an influence on how we want to treat it, maybe how we display it. We have various ways of doing that. Often we just look under magnification, but we also may look in raking light. That's a very good way of seeing planar deformations and will give us some insight into how the paint was applied. We also have different kind of light sources, like we use UV light. Some pigments will fluoresce and often varnishes will fluoresce, which can give us a lot of information about the surface of the painting. We also may use x-rays. X-rays will give us sort of a map of the density of the painting. When you see images of x-rays, you can see underlayers of paint or how the composition was changed. So that's another way that we can gather information about the painting. And all of this kind of feeds into our understanding of how the painting was made and can sometimes give us clues as to why it may look the way it does or how it might have changed. We also have a lot of analytical techniques at the museum that we can use, things like XRF, which is X-ray fluorescence. We have a gun that we point at paintings and it shoots X-rays at them and it tells us what elements are in that paint. We've got a whole wealth of ways and means of finding out what an artist has used and how that might influence what we want to do to the painting.
But we can do all of this in our conservation studio, and we always use materials that we know to be stable, to last for a long time, and things that won't get brittle or harden with age. Everything that we do in conservation, except for consolidation, is reversible. We don't generally want a consolidation to be reversible because we want that paint to stay on the surface of the painting. But everything else that we use can be removed in the future with no impact on the surface of the painting. Another part of our role here at Agwedd Cymru is to lend our works out both nationally within Wales, within the UK more broadly, and also internationally. So paintings could end up travelling really quite far. And this is a great way to build up some publicity for our collections. Conservation in general is quite a new profession. Although paintings have been restored for years, centuries, it was never a regulated profession. And you do find that restorers of the past sometimes caused the damage that we're now trying to fix. We're always doing research into how to do the things that we do better, how to keep things minimal, and how to keep our materials reversible.